I made this scene in 50 days, and in this video, I'm going to go over my process of building the scene, challenges I encountered, and some useful tips I learned along the way. Most good scenes start with reference and some sort of inspiration. Behance has some really good inspiration for exteriors, interiors, urban, city environments. But I think it's important to go outside and see something interesting. Reference can be good for finer details. In my case, going outside gives me the inspiration to get started on a project. In the beginning, I create the basic shapes for the important parts of the scene, like the buildings and any props that are prominently featured. Some buildings are more complex than others. Modern buildings are usually pretty simple. The way I like to do this is start with one building, then move on to the next. I like to work with separate pieces, that way it's easier to deal with topology and modifiers. Smaller objects can sometimes take a while, and it can feel like you're not making progress because it's a small object. It's still important to do it though, because even if it's like far away in the distance, like you can still tell that something seems off when it's not there. So here's the scene like without props. And then as we add the props, you can see it makes the scene a little more lively. Evidently, it's important to add things like fences, door handles, street lamps. After that, it's onto the windows, where you have to be a bit careful, especially when it comes to adjusting the size so that it lines up with the edge of the building. But I'm just using an array for that. You can see that I'm zooming in a lot to get it positioned just right. So I used a curve for the curb, which I thought was a little easier than the other methods. I'm just going to mirror this along the center, making sure that the origin is on that center vertex there. And then to get the curb shape, I'm going to extrude it and then solidify it. From there, it's a matter of adjusting the subdivisions, moving the vertices around, adding vertices where needed. I probably didn't need to add a subdivision modifier because curves actually have subdivision in the curve settings. As far as UV unwrapping is concerned, I just convert it to a mesh. I'm not sure if there's another way. There are two buildings in this scene. One of them is a bit bigger. Adding windows is a major part of this one because in my reference, the windows are actually different sizes. There's a lot of randomness when it comes to the windows here, but the overall building design by contrast is extremely simple. Just don't forget your bevel. Now I did add a glass panel because sometimes the material in between the outside wall and the inside wall can get a bit messed up. This was one thing that got pretty annoying. I had to use hole tolerant in some instances. Now another curb here. So here you can see me struggling with topology. This took me like 15 to 20 minutes, and this was actually my second time doing this because my original is what you're gonna see at the end. I'm probably going a little bit overkill here. If you're not working with a rigged model, then it doesn't really matter that your geometry is all quads. And that being said, later on I added displacement, so I tried to have mostly square faces. Retopology is one of those things that can be difficult the first time. There are tools that can just do this automatically. I usually don't like using displacement, but for this scene I wanted to give it a try. It made a slight difference. This is before I added displacement. I set it to 0.3, which I thought was too much. 0.08 I thought was good. So there it is, off again, on again. Just extruding things out at this point and adding loop cuts. Next to the corner there is probably the hardest part because I needed enough geometry there to get that curve that's rounded, but then I don't need that much geometry for the other parts. It just makes dealing with topology easier. And the final step here is to solidify the sidewalk. So my lighting setup is actually using two different HDRs. This one's only affecting the camera, like it's visible, but it's not affecting the lighting. And then this one is only affecting the lighting and it's not actually visible. And the way you do that is using a light path and plugging the camera ray into this mix shader here. And I mean, if you wanted to, you could use a sky texture and use that for the lighting, but I find that the sky texture is kind of finicky. It's a bit difficult to get these settings right, and in this case, it wasn't really working that well in my opinion. Now for the road, I added a tiny bit of displacement. I'm just using a clouds texture for that. I felt that without the displacement, it just looked a little bit unnatural. off there, and then on again. Now, I actually used the scatter add-on to generate some falling leaves. One thing that I did have to do is animate the consistent movement in one direction, like the wind. You can see this value is animated here. Starts at around -6, and then it goes to 0. And then these are my settings for the falling animation.